Knowing how to compose and send email with attachments is extremely important for online learning. Open mail.google.com in Mozilla Firefox. You may need to click Sign In at the top. Your username is the Blackboard username at student.montgomery.edu. After entering it, click Next. Your initial password is the same one you used to log into Blackboard for the first time. Enter the password. Uncheck Stay Signed In and click Sign In. If you have issues signing in, please contact someone in distance learning. To create a message, click the Compose button. Enter the recipient's email address in the To box. As you start to type, you will be given options from the address book. Click on the recipient. If you are contacting someone outside the school, ensure that the address is entered perfectly, otherwise it won't be delivered. An alternative way of doing this would be to click on the word To, then you can search for the recipient. Notice the CC and BCC links. CC is used to send a carbon copy of the message to someone. BCC is used to send a blind carbon copy to someone. Addresses listed in the BCC box won't appear in the message header. BCC is useful if you are contacting a group and don't want everyone to be able to see all of the addresses. Next, enter a meaningful subject. Start with the course number and section so that the instructor can easily identify the course you are enrolled in. Your course numbers and section numbers can be found on your registration receipt. Then, include a few words describing the email. An example subject could be XYZ101W1 Test 1 Question 2 Error. This lets the instructor know that you are in the XYZ101W1 course and that you think there may be an error in question number 2 on test 1. Enter a properly written message with a greeting, complete sentences with proper grammar and punctuation, and a closing. An example message for this inquiry could be written as follows. Notice the professional writing style. The student is fairly certain the answer is wrong, yet she sends a calm, passive message to request assistance. It is extremely important for you to be specific when you ask questions. One of the earlier course orientation videos provided tips concerning this. After composing and proofreading the message, click the paperclip icon to attach a file. For this example, there's a screenshot of the test question. Click the flash drive on the left. Double-click the folder. Double-click the file. Watch the progress bar. If you attach the wrong file, click the small X to remove it. Repeat the process to attach the correct file. Click Send. Click Sent Mail on the left to verify it was sent. If an instructor states that he didn't receive your email, you can always show you did actually send it by showing him the Sent Items folder. Keep all sent items throughout your college career. Now let's take a look at replying to an email. Click on the email. Click the Reply button. Or click the drop-down arrow on the reply button for more options such as forwarding. Use caution with the reply all button if responding to a message that was sent to a group. Don't use that option unless you really do want everyone to see your reply. I like to click on the type of response button and select edit subject. You always want the subject to reflect what's in the message. click the full screen button. Click OK, got it. Enter a properly written reply, attach files if appropriate, and click Send. Do not ignore email from instructors. Always reply and be honest even when you've done something wrong, as shown in this example about attendance issues. Lastly, don't forget to check your spam folder a few times weekly. Click More on the left. Click the Spam link. Sometimes legit email is erroneously routed into spam. For security reasons, always sign out when finished with email. Click your icon in the upper right corner. Click Sign Out.